Parkridge High School, and welcome back to Owl Witness News. This is the 15th episode, and today is Friday, February 12th, 2021. Let's get right into these announcements. Attention all seniors. Caps and gowns will be distributed on today, Friday, February 12th, from 12:45 to 1:15 p.m. at the main entrance. Please make every effort to pick up your cap and gown at this time.
Don't miss your chance to grab your very own Parkridge knit hat. Staff and students who are working remotely can email Sean and Becky at parkridge.k12.nj.us to set up a time or day when they'd like to pick up their hat and begin showing off their school spirit.
Students in grades 9 through 12, please submit your artwork and or writing to Imprints Literary Magazine. Have you been sculpting, painting, composing music, making short films, or writing poetry, short stories, or scripts? Please share with us. Email your submissions to imprints at parkridge.k12.nj.us.
Please pick up all semester one ceramic projects as soon as possible.
Now let's go over to our very own Ryan with our Super Bowl score prediction.
No time for intros today.
Super Bowl. It happened. Out of 75 guesses, no one guessed the score correctly. The closest was fellow OWN member Josh Sudanowitz, who said the Bucks would take it 31-28. And the farthest was Mikey DeMar, who said the Chiefs would win 3,789 to negative 98.
Josh, did you know Valentine's Day is this weekend?
Surprisingly, I did, Vito. I may be single, but I know some of our viewers are not. Let's go over to our special Valentine's Day segment.
Today, in honor of Valentine's Day,
OWN crew decided to write each other anonymous compliments. Valentine's.
You know, to lift one another up, encourage one another. You know, I'm a big team morale guy, and there's a lot of love to be spread on this team.
Maybe I'll use this as the chance to break the will of some of my opponents, anonymously.
Alright, so I just got my Valentine, and now I'm gonna read it.
You know, this is gonna be really fun. I just got mine in the mail. Let's open this up.
Okay, so I got a letter.
I didn't even want to do this. Valentine's Day is so lame. It's just a holiday for corporations to make more money and profit off of love.
I know I said, and I asked Josh if he knew it was Valentine's Day. I'm not gonna lie, I really didn't know.
Alright, let's see what we got here.
But yeah, so we got a nice little letter here.
So I just got my Valentine's Day letter. It's on this piece of paper.
But everyone else wanted to do this, so I guess I got to open this.
What do we got here? Josh, you look like Henry Danger. Who is Henry? Hold on.
It's pretty dirty and wrinkled. At least put some more effort into this.
Let's open it up. I was in the Joker.
It doesn't have who it's from, but it says, "You are genuinely the most scary person I've ever met. You're kind of terrifying."
Kelsey, you're really good at editing. Plus, you kick so many butts of kids on Roblox.
Yeah, I love it. Thank you. So sweet of you. I didn't know that.
Wait, that's really sweet. That's like the best compliment I've ever received. Maybe Valentine's Day is okay.
Come back, Keith. We miss you, fam.
Thank you, and that's so sweet. That reminds me of the one that I made for Lindsay. Wait. If I have the letter for Lindsay here, what did I send her?
It's blank. Huh.
All right.
Henry Danger. Images. Oh!
Not gonna complain. No, it's just... Read the note.
You think you're real cool, huh?
Thank you. Yeah.
It's not much of a compliment.
I know you cheated in Tetris.
Here's some crumbs from my last cupcake batch in case you wanted to see what real baking tastes like. XOXO Jenny.
I went through so much training to get that high score, and now I'm being called a cheater.
Roses are red, violets are blue. Next time we bake, I'll poison your food. XOXO Madison.
There are approximately 1,010,300 words in the English language, but I can never string together enough words to properly express how bad you are at carving pumpkins.
I would be a way better host of trivia than you.
Dash, you know who.
It's gotta mean something, right? I mean, no one would just send me like a blank piece of paper. Maybe they just couldn't put into words how much they like me.
You know what, Jenny? I do not appreciate this. I do not.
Oh, so you didn't put poison in the last ones? I thought you did, based on the judges' reactions.
Are these supposed to be compliments?
That was worth it.
That didn't work out at all.
And that's all for today, Parkridge High School. Have a good weekend, stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll see you next time.
Of all the ways I expected that to go, never would have expected it to go bad.
It was great. I'm very thankful.
I would like to use this time to apologize to Lindsay.
I think it might take a little bit for me to recover from that.
I hope Madison enjoyed the crumbs.
Look, when you're a high-profile school news show personality like me, someone's gonna be jealous. There's always gonna be haters.
I was actually looking forward to this. I'm a loving guy and a lovable guy.
Alexa, play Marvin's Room.
I'm sorry, Lindsay. I had your letter. I swear it's literally right here. I don't know how I ended up mailing you a blank piece of paper.
Like I said before, I don't like Valentine's Day, but after receiving that compliment, I think I might have to like it now.
Not a good look on me. No, not at all.
Great, 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 great compliment. Yeah, I know. Thank you, I think.
But I do hope that you know that those non-existent words came from the heart.
Because obviously someone on the team is in love with me.
But, I don't know. Maybe my expectations were too high.